Easter season, and I just wanted to sing through the Gloria so that you remember what it sounds like, and you can be sure to join along when we get there during the liturgy. So I'm just going to sing through it first with the band, and then I'll invite you guys all to join in, so feel free to sing along as always. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. Maybe we can do it one more time. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. Just a reminder, if you're looking for any of the words for the liturgy today, just scan the barcode on the pews in front of you on the little postcard, and it'll take you directly to all of the words and lyrics for today's liturgy. Thank you.
name is Mary, and our presider is Father John Ahern. In a special way today, we welcome Jesse Heap, Jerry Lala, Dawn Cortez, Jordan Macy, Carmen DeVito, and Dorothy Coyne, who will all be commissioned as Stephen ministers at the end of Mass. During the Easter season, we hear how the disciples encounter the risen Christ at different times and in different ways, all the while trying to understand the meaning of the resurrection. We too contemplate the implications of the resurrection and consider how we see the risen Lord in our lives. It helps us to gather as church where we can seek the presence of Christ as we worship, in the assembly, in its ministers, in the Word of God, in the Holy Sacrifice, and in the Eucharist. Let us pray that we may better discern the Lord in our midst. The bread and wine this week have been donated in loving memory of Frank Luzzi.
As we begin our celebration, I invite you all to rise and join with us in singing All Are Welcome, number 753 in the Green Gatherbook. Let us build a house where love can dwell, and all can safely live, a place where saints and children tell how hearts learn to forgive, built of hopes and dreams and visions, rock of faith and vault of grace. Here the love of Christ shall end division.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Good morning, everyone. As we heard in the beginning of our Mass, we're very pleased at this Mass. We'll be commissioning six new Stephen ministers to serve the needy in our parish. We're also thrilled to have our RCIA team back with us. Now during a period of what's called mystagogy, in the time after they're welcomed into the church to learn even more about the faith and to continue their faith journey. So we are thrilled you are here with us today as well. And as we come together as a community of faith, we pause for a moment to consider our sins and to ask God for pardon and for peace. Lord Jesus, companion on our journey, you suffered and died to bring us salvation. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, living word of God, you are the source of new life for all who put their trust in you. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, advocate with the Father, you are the way that leads to eternal life. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people.
People exult forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. This morning's Mass is offered for the repose of the soul of Bernadette Che, Francis and Lucille Marshall, Jane McHugh, and Joseph Scala.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the Holy and Righteous One and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you have put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away." The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. My children, I am writing this to you so that you may not commit sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous one. He is expiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but for those of the whole world. The way that we may be sure that we know him is to keep his commandments. Those who say, I know him, but do not keep his commandments are liars, and the truth is not in them. But whoever keeps his word, the love of God is truly perfected in him. The word of the Lord. From the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The two disciples recounted what had taken place on the way and how Jesus was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. While they were still speaking about this, Jesus stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." But they were startled and terrified and thought they were seeing a ghost. Then Jesus said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do questions arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet. See that it is I, myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you can see that I have."
And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While they were still incredulous with joy and were amazed, Jesus asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" Then they gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. He said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you. And everything written about me in the law of Moses and in the prophets and in the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Christ would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance for the forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
So there's an old joke. A man is at the end of a long line waiting to get into heaven. And he listens as he's getting closer and closer to the pearly gates. And he realizes that St. Peter asked the person, two people ahead of him, "All right, well, what's your religion?" And the guy says, "Methodist." And St. Peter says, "Okay, go to room 12, but be very quiet when you pass room number 8. And then the next guy goes forward, and St. Peter says to him, "What religion are you?" And he says, "I'm Lutheran." He says, "Okay, you can go to room 16, but be very, very quiet when you pass room number 8. And so finally, it's the man's turn online, and St. Peter says to him, "What religion are you?" And he says, "I'm Episcopalian. But before you tell me where to go, why do we all have to be quiet when passing room number 8? And St. Peter says, "Oh, that's where the Catholics are. They think they're the only ones here." And you know, it's a cute little joke, but it makes us wonder, what is heaven going to be like? What is this resurrected life going to be like? Will there be Protestants there? I don't know. Will dogs and cats be allowed into heaven? I don't know. How old will we be when we're in heaven? And actually, that's a question a lot of theologians have asked, and many agree we'll all be 33 years old, the year that Jesus died. Kind of the perfect age. So that might be good news or bad news for you, depending on where you are. But there is one thing that we can be sure of that has a lot of scriptural basis to it. And that is, what will we look like in heaven? What will we look like in heaven? And in his letter to the Philippians, St. Paul writes, "Our lowly bodies will be glorified and be like the body of Christ." So these bodies we have now, they will be glorified and by Christ to look like Christ. And that's a wonderful thing to imagine, that we'll be somehow look like who we are, but fully glorified. But there's one catch. There's one catch. In today's gospel, Jesus' glorified body has wounds. Jesus' glorified body has wounds. He tells the apostles in today's gospel, "Look at my hands and my feet," so that they would know who he is. In last week's gospel, he told St. Thomas, "Put your hands in my wounds so that you can know that it is me." Jesus' glorified body has wounds, which means that our glorified body will have wounds. That our glorified body will somehow bear the marks and the dings and the dents and the sorrows and the burdens that we've carried on in this life. Which means there is something about our wounds that are glorious. There is something about the wounds we pick up in this world that will make us more like Christ. And there are three ways, perhaps, we can think about it. One is that Christ has wounds because he took a risk. Christ is wounded because he took a risk. When God created humanity, God could have created just a bunch of robots who would mindly do God's will. But God decided no. He gave us free will in order that we could love. And because we have free will, we can love, but we can also sin. And when God decided to redeem us, God could have chosen any number of ways to do it. But God took another risk. He sent his only son into the world to walk with us. And Jesus' life was one marked by risk. He didn't just stay at home in Nazareth. He traveled all around Judea. Jesus spent 40 days in the desert and took the risk to figure out who he really was and what God wanted him to do. Jesus took a risk and ate with sinners and tax collectors and saints and prostitutes and everyone in between. Jesus took a risk and challenged Roman authority and said there's a different way to govern this world. Jesus took a risk and said there's a different way to love and serve God than by following rules. Jesus took a risk. And because of that risk, he received wounds. And those wounds glorified him. How often are we willing to take risks in our life and in our faith? It's so easy to avoid any wounds and play it safe, to just do what we've always done, to let other people tell us who we are and how we are to think. But to bear these wounds of Christ, we need to take risks as Christ did. We need to spend time in our own deserts, figuring out who we are and how God calls us to be. We need to take risks by standing up for the poor and the marginalized in our world. We need to take risks and speak out and call the church to do a better job of who the church is meant to be. We need to take risks, as so many have done today. We have these RCIA candidates who took a risk in their journey of faith. These Stephen ministers who heard something about Stephen ministry and said, I'm going to take a risk. I'm going to step outside my comfort zone and not just sit in the pews week after week, but put my faith into practice. And if we, when we do that, we open up new levels of faith and understanding we never had before. Or we fail miserably and are wounded as a result. But those wounds are glorious. Those wounds make us more like Christ. Christ was also wounded because he loved. Christ has wounds because he loved. In the gospel, he tells us, there is no greater love than this, than to lay down one's life for one's friends. And because of that love, Christ was wounded, and Christ was glorified. What about the wounds we received because we have loved? Is there anything more glorious than a woman who bears stretch marks or a little extra weight because she's given birth to children? Is there anything more glorious than a pair of hands, calloused and raw and wounded because they work to support their family? Is there anything more glorious than the wounded, tired face of a teacher or a coach or a volunteer who gives so much to their community? Is there anything more glorious than a broken heart, a heart that is loved and didn't receive loved back, or a heart that loved and their loved one passed away, or a heart that loved and for whatever reason, that love, that relationship is broken and ruptured? The wounds sometimes we bear are because we have loved. And that love is glorious. And that love will lead us to Christ. And finally, the wounds of Christ are wounds of beauty and strength. There is a great Japanese art called kintsugi. And it began when a samurai broke one of his favorite teacups and it shattered. And when he sent it to be put back together, the artist didn't try to cover up the crack and hide it with paint, but rather they took gold and poured gold into the crack and highlighted the crack and made the crack beautiful, something to be emulated, and made the cup stronger as a result. Sometimes in our woundedness, that's where the beauty is. That's where the strength is. That's what makes something beautiful and precious and glorious. The wounds of Christ did that. Christ's glory shone forth through the wounds on his side, in his hands, and in his feet. And our woundedness too, That's where God will show and shine more brightly within us. So I don't know if there are going to be dogs in heaven. I don't know if there's going to be cats in heaven. I doubt it, but there you are. But what I do know will be in heaven is our glorified bodies with our wounds, the wounds from which the glory of God shines more brightly on this world. And no offense to any cat people, just want to get that clear. Let us stand now and profess our faith. During the Easter season, we profess our faith with the more ancient version, the Apostles' Creed, which can be found on page 8 of your Spirit and Song hymnal. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Jesus did not want his disciples to remain troubled, so he assured them of his continuing presence. We now bring the needs that trouble us before the Lord, assured of God's presence in our neediness.
For the church, that we may be witness to the risen Lord, revealing his presence in our acts of mercy and love, and bringing his healing touch to those in need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are in authority, that they may pursue justice, right the wrongs that persist, and lift up those who are oppressed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the peace given by the risen Lord to his disciples may continue to spread and flower all over the world, let us pray to the Lord. For those who were welcomed into the church during the Easter Vigil, and for all those who will be making their First Communion during this Easter season, that they may know Christ in a special way during this time of joy, let us pray to the Lord. For those who are ill, imprisoned, homeless, or neglected, that they and those who care for them may recognize the Lord in each other. Let us pray to the Lord. For lasting peace and justice in the Middle East, in all war-torn areas of the world, let us pray to the Lord. For our soon-to-be commissioned Stephen ministers, let us pray to the Lord. For the recently deceased Diane Alicia, let us pray to the Lord. For the intentions of this Mass, Bernadette Shea, Francis and Lucille Marshall, Jane McHugh, Joseph Scala, let us pray to the Lord.
Heavenly God, your Son reveals himself in the gifts we bring, the sacrifice we celebrate, and the Eucharist we receive. Help us to see him in each other as we make our prayers through him, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Please be seated.
Please join me this in singing Peace I Leave, number 350 in the Spirit and Songbook.
Peace.
So may you give it to peace.
Sacrifice in yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but during this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion. He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be poured out for you and for the many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we
as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Kevin, our Bishop, the clergy, and all people of goodwill. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, the glorious martyrs, the apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Coming together as one family of faith, let us offer our prayer to the Father. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Thank you.
be seated. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Anyone who requires a gluten-free host should go to the priest distributing communion in the front of the church and request a gluten-free host. As we come forward to receive communion, please join with us in singing In the Breaking of the Bread, number 369 in the Spirit and Songbook.
In the breaking of the bread.
Burning as he spoke.
but you could breathe and leave a trail of galaxies and dream of me. What kind of love is writing my story till the end with mercy's pen? Only you. What kind of king would choose to wear a crown that bleeds and scars to win my heart? What kind of love tells me I'm the reason he can stay inside the grave? You. Standing here before my eyes, every part of my heart cries, alive, alive. Look what mercy's overcome. Death has lost and love has won. Just one name. What other heart would let itself be broken every time till he healed mine? You, only you, could turn my darkness into dawn, running right into your arms.
Thank you.
A few announcements before we commission our new Stephen ministers. Volunteers from the military assistance pantry will be handing out brownie and ziti pans after Mass this weekend. Please consider baking or cooking for our veterans. They really look forward to it. Our Sister of Cornerstone Women are hosting a game night on Thursday, April 18th. Details are in the bulletin. And I'd now like to invite Carrie to come forward to tell us about an event coming up next week here at St. Mary's.
Hi, everyone. Thank you. I can read cards, so thank you. No. We started this Mass with one of our favorite and beloved songs of this parish, All Are Welcome. And as we've welcomed the RCIA candidates, and now they are full members, as we get ready to welcome our Stevens ministers who are going to be newly commissioned, I have another group who I'd love to invite, and it's brides and grooms, along with all of us in our community. We are thrilled to announce that St. Mary's will be hosting a bridal expo on Saturday, this coming Saturday, April 20th, from 12 to 3 over in the Carnevale Center. We are excited for this opportunity to support and reach out to local businesses, as well as share with the outside community who don't know St. Mary's just yet, how wonderful this place would be for a couple to spend their wedding day here. So, the admission is free if there's online registration beforehand, or it's $5 at the door. Feel free to go online, it's in the bulletin, it's online, the registration codes are there. And we look forward to making this a wonderful event. And even if you directly are not having somebody in your family, you know, get married, or please invite people and please come out, support our local businesses, and all are welcome. Thank you.
Thank you, Carrie. Now we'd like to celebrate the following two women and four men in our parish who have completed over 50 hours of training to be fully commissioned as Stephen ministers. I ask those to be commissioned to come forward to the top step and face the congregation. Dawn Cortez, Dorothy Coyne, Carmine DeVito, Jesse Heap, Jerry Lala, and Jordan Macy. If you could come forward and stand on the top step. My friends, the mission statement of St. Mary Stephen Ministry is, in the spirit of St. Francis, who lived the gospel of compassion and love, St. Mary Stephen Ministry provides one-to-one Christian care by putting our faith into action and extending the healing touch of Christ to our sisters and brothers who are experiencing life's challenges. And so I ask you, are you prepared to meet the needs of the care receivers who will be assigned to you? Yes. Are you prepared to nurture the skills you have learned and use them in service to others, to support, encourage, build up, and comfort people in all of their needs? Yes. And now, members of the St. Mary's Church, I ask you, are you willing to open your hearts to the ministry of these people and to pray for them so that they may be effective servants of Christ? If you are prepared to meet this request, answer, yes, with the help of God.
Yes, with the help of God.
My friends, because you have promised faithfully to serve the Lord Jesus and his people as Stephen ministers, I commend and commission you to the care and guidance of the Holy Spirit as you in turn care for others. Work hard. Use the skills you have learned, releasing the gifts and talents of the Spirit of God you have been given, so that you might be a blessing to the people you meet and care for. And may Almighty God bless you now and always, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's give our newly commissioned Stephen ministers a round of applause. I'd like to give a special thanks to one of our Stephen leaders, Bill Moen, who is responsible for training this class of Stephen ministers. And And I'd like to ask Bill and all of our Stephen ministers here present to stand so we can show our appreciation for all of your hard work and dedication. As I mentioned, it takes a great deal of risk to come forward and try a new ministry. It also takes a great deal of risk to reach out and say that you need help. But these Stephen ministers are here and are wonderfully trained to help anyone suffering through grief or anxiety, a job loss, any situation you might need help with. They are here to help you. So please don't hesitate to reach out to me or the Stephen ministry number in the bulletin. Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Please join me this in singing Go Ye Out, number 110 in the Spirit and Songbook.